The third type of thermal expansion is the volume expansion. Therefore, volume expansion means the increase in volume due to heating is called as volume or cubical expansion. Now see in the figure. From figure, we observe that if the substance is in the form of a cube of a volume V, then for small change delta T in temperature, the fractional change delta V by V in a volume is directly proportional to delta T. Therefore, mathematically we can say that delta V by V is directly proportional to delta T, or delta V by V is equal to gamma into delta T, where gamma is called as coefficient of cubical or volume expansion. It depends upon the nature of the material. Its unit is per degree Celsius or per Kelvin. From equation, delta V by V is equal to gamma into delta T, we can write here gamma is equal to delta V by V into delta T is equal to Vt minus V0 upon V0 into T minus T0, where V0 is the volume at 0 degree centigrade. Vt is the volume when heated to T degree centigrade. T0 is the initial temperature. T is the final temperature. Delta V is the Vt minus V0, means change in volume. Delta T is the T minus T0, means rise in temperature. And if V is equal to 1 meter cube and T minus T0 is equal to 1 degree centigrade, then gamma becomes as a Vt minus V0, which gets numerically. Therefore, the coefficient of cubical expansion of a solid is defined as the increase in volume per unit original volume at 0 degree centigrade for 1 degree rise in the temperature. If V1 is the volume of a body at T1 degree centigrade and V2 is the volume at a higher temperature T2 degree centigrade, then gamma is equal to V2 minus V1 upon V1 into T2 minus T1, where gamma is the coefficient of volume expansion at T1 degree centigrade. Since fluids possess definite volume and take the shape of the container, only change in volume which is a significant one. Now, the equations gamma is equal to Vt minus V0 upon V0 into T minus T0, and the equation gamma 1 is equal to V2 minus V1 upon V1 into T2 minus T1, these two equations are valid for cubical or volume expansion of fluids. It is to be noted that the fluids are kept in containers when one deals with the volume expansion of a fluid, and the expansion of the container is also considered. If expansion of fluid results in a volume, which one is greater than the volume of the container? The fluid will overflow if the container is open. If the container is closed, volume expansion of fluid will cause additional pressure on the walls of the container. Normally, solids and liquids expands on heating, means their volume increases on heating. Since the mass, which one is a constant, means it results in a decrease in the density on heating. Okay, now we have also learned about the analogous behavior of water, and water expands on cooling from 4 degree centigrade to 0 degree centigrade. Hence, its density decreases on cooling in this temperature range. Now, we can see here also there is a table which gives the typical average values of the coefficient of volume expansion, means gamma, for some materials in the temperature range 0 degree centigrade to 100 degree centigrade. See, there is a table which gives the value of the coefficient of volume expansion for some common materials. See, in the table there are materials and there are the values of gamma, means the coefficient of volume expansion for these materials. See, first the material is involved having the value of gamma, which is 2 into 10 raised to minus 6. Then glass having the value of gamma, which is 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 5. Then steel has 3.3 to 3.9 into 10 raised to minus 5. Then iron has 3.55 into 10 raised to minus 5. Then gold has a gamma 4.2 into 10 raised to minus 5. Then brass has the value of gamma, which one is 5.7 into 10 raised to minus 5. Then for aluminium, it's 6.9 into 10 raised to minus 5. Then for mercury, it's 18.2 into 10 raised to minus 5. Then for water, it's 20.7 into 10 raised to minus 5. Then for paraffin, it's 58.8 into 10 raised to minus 5. Then for gasoline, it's 95 into 10 raised to minus 5. And lastly, for alcohol, it's 110 into 10 raised to minus 5. Also, gamma is also characteristic of the substance, but it is not strictly constant. See, gamma means the coefficient of volume expansion, which is also the characteristic of the substance, but it's not strictly a constant. It depends in a general on the temperature. It depends on the temperature, which is shown in this graph. This graph shows the gamma, which becomes constant only at high temperatures. See, from this graph, gamma becomes constant only at high temperature. Then see the next point, which gives the relation between coefficient of expansion. Next article is the relation between coefficients of expansion. First, we will see the relation between beta and alpha, means the coefficient of areal and linear expansion. Consider a square plate of side L0 at 0 degree centigrade and LT at T degree centigrade. Therefore, LT is equal to L0 into 1 plus alpha T. This is from equation. Alpha is equal to LT minus L0 upon L0 into T minus T0. If area of a plate at 0 degree centigrade, which one is A0, therefore A0 becomes L0 square. If area of a plate at a T degree centigrade, then its is a AT. Okay. So AT becomes LT square is equal to L0 square into 1 plus alpha T square. Or AT, which is equals to A0 1 plus alpha T square. Okay, say that equation 1. Also from equation beta, we know that the equation of beta AT minus A0 upon A0 into T minus T0. Therefore, AT becomes A0 into 1 plus beta T. From this equation and this equation, we get that equation, which is the A0, 1 plus alpha T square is equal to A0 1 plus beta T. Okay. Or 1 plus 2 alpha T plus alpha square T square is equal to 1 plus beta T. Since the values of alpha are very small, the term alpha square T square is also very small and may be neglected. Therefore, we get beta is equal to 2 alpha. This is the result, which is general, because any solid can be regarded as a collection of small squares. Then see the relation between gamma and alpha. See the relation between gamma and alpha. Consider a cube of side L0 at 0 degree centigrade and LT at T degree centigrade. Therefore, LT becomes L0 into 1 plus alpha T. This is from equation alpha is equal to LT minus L0 upon L0 into T minus T0. If volume of the cube at 0 degree centigrade is V0, therefore volume at 0 degree centigrade, it becomes V0 equals to L0 cube. Okay. If volume of the cube at T degree centigrade, then see VT, it becomes LT cube equals to L0 cube 1 plus alpha T cube. Or VT is equal to V0 into 1 plus alpha T cube. Also from equation, gamma is equal to VT minus V0 upon V0 into T minus T0. From that equation, we will get VT is equal to V0 into 1 plus gamma T. Or using these two equations, means VT is equal to V0 1 plus alpha T cube, or VT is equal to V0 1 plus gamma T. From these two equations, we get, using these two equations, we get V0 1 plus alpha T cube is equal to V0 1 plus gamma T, or 1 plus 3 alpha T plus 3 alpha square T square plus alpha cube T cube equals to 1 plus gamma T. Since the values of alpha are very small, means the terms with the higher powers of alpha may be neglected. Therefore, get the gamma equals to 3 alpha. Again, the result is general. Okay. Because any solid can be regarded as a collection of small cubes. Therefore, finally, the relation between alpha, beta and gamma, which one is alpha equals to beta upon 2 and equals to gamma upon 3. This is the relation between alpha, beta and gamma. Alpha equals to beta upon 2 equals to gamma upon 3.